The other day I deployed a new feature into my Vue app and went to bed and found myself haunted by the nightmares that I would wake up to the app being on fire because I accidentally introduced a new bug. If this scenario sounds like something you've experienced before, we can reduce this kind of stress and strengthen our Vue apps by using unit testing. Unit testing is the foundation of a well-tested application, and it might be a part of a larger testing suite that includes snapshot testing and E2E, or end-to-end testing. But since unit testing is the foundation and majority of testing you'll do, this course will focus solely on unit testing using Jest and Vue Test Utils. Jest is a popular JavaScript library for actually running your tests, and we will infuse this with the power of Vue Test Utils. This will allow us to test every unit of our application, making sure the different parts of our application are behaving like they ought to. So what are some of the benefits of writing unit tests? Well, first off, we're going to improve our code quality because we'll deploy less bugs, and writing components with testing in mind means we'll end up with more isolated, reusable components. Testing can also boost confidence because you know that you're shipping code that actually works, and this leads to better documentation because a suite of unit tests shows you how that component ought to behave. So what exactly should we be testing? Well, since the units of a Vue app are components, we should be focusing on testing components. So let's look at a simple example. Let's say we have a simple component that generates a random number, and it uses two props, a min and max number, as the range to generate that random number, which it then renders to the DOM. So how would we go about testing this component? Well, it's helpful when testing to think about the component contract. By that, I mean the agreement that this component has about its purpose within the scope of the larger application. So this component's contract says, I will accept two props and use them to generate and display a random number. So looking at this contract, we can break this down into inputs and outputs. The inputs are the min and max props, and the output is that generated number, which is rendered to the DOM. Some more inputs include component data, props, user interaction, such as a button click, lifecycle methods, the Vuex store, and route params. Outputs are things like what is rendered to the DOM, external function calls, events emitted by the component, updates to the Vuex store, and changes within child components. So let's look at another simple example to get more practice identifying inputs and outputs. Here we have an app header component, and we have this logged in data, which determines whether we're displaying the logout button or not. So the data here would be considered an input. At first, this terminology might seem confusing because, unlike props, data isn't being input into the component, but really, an input is anything that affects the output. So some dynamic state within our component is considered an input. And the output, of course, is going to be this button, which is either rendered or not. So we're starting to understand what we should be testing, but what about what we should not be testing? We could be wasting a lot of time testing things that we don't have to. So looking again at this example, we know we want to test the rendered output, but what about the logic that actually computes that number? Should we be testing this method? The answer here is simply no, because this is considered an implementation detail. While it might seem counterintuitive, with unit testing, we're not concerned about how the component did what it did. We just want to know that it did what it was supposed to, that it gave us the output we were expecting. By not focusing on implementation details, we won't be breaking the test if we changed the way we were computing that random number in the future. Another thing we shouldn't be testing is the Vue framework itself. For example, if we added some prop validation, setting these props to be of type number, we don't have to test this validation. We can trust Evan Yu and his team have done an awesome job doing testing themselves. We don't have to do their job for them. The same goes for third-party libraries. If this component were using Axios to make an API call, for example, we don't need to be testing that Axios works. We can assume that that library is well tested. Of course, if our output is dependent upon an API call we're making, we're going to be testing that output, but we don't need to be testing Axios itself. So now that you know about the component contract, breaking apart its inputs and outputs, and not over-testing what you shouldn't be, I'll see you in the next lesson where we'll write our first unit test.